guys. How you doing? This is my horse, Bob. Quarter horse. And he's a really good boy. My name is Nick, and I'm going to show you guys how to properly saddle a horse. Now, he's real clean. I just brushed him. And you want to make sure your horse is clean. No stickers or anything that can poke him or make him act funny when you're riding him. Especially down here where the cinch goes. He's all clean, and I don't need to tie him up because he's a good boy, but you probably should yours if he's a little rambunctious. And I like to start by first getting a good saddle pad. This one's curved, and he's got quite a curve to his back, high withers. This is what you want from him. You want to have him so it's not over his hip here, and it's far enough forward. You set it on there just like that. And then I like to get a blanket, this Navajo blanket here, fold it in half, put that on top of this, and that gives them some extra padding, and it looks nice. And then we come over to the saddle, and you can throw your cinch and your stirrup and everything over here, so it's not caught underneath them when you're trying to put it on. And I like to keep a pad on the stand too, just to kind of protect the wool and the bottom of the saddle and keep it clean. And you can get these pretty cheap for like $20 and just keep it on your saddle stand there. And so what you do, throw it on them like this. And you want to make sure you have it far enough forward and not over the hips. You want this D-ring to go straight down right to here. You don't want it back here or up here too high. You want it right there. You want to make sure you always got a lot of clearance between the withers and the fork here. Otherwise, it can be really uncomfortable for a horse if that's riding on the withers. Now I go to the other side. And let this stuff down. Make sure you get everything out. Set this here. Make sure nothing's bound up, make sure your cinch doesn't have any stickers on them or anything that's gonna bug them. Come over to the other side, put your stirrup up on the horn. Now this Latigo's got holes in it, which is nice. There's two ways to tie this. Some cowboys like to do it one way and some people like to do it another. Keep it kind of loose and make a couple loops here so you don't have a whole bunch of slack, and just tighten it up, you know, so it's tight. Some horses will take an air when you're doing this, and then when you ride them, they'll let out the air and they'll get loose again. So what you want to do is get off and retighten it and just put that through that. And this like this. And I like to have a cinch that has padding underneath the metal hardware here, so it doesn't, so it's not laying on his side hurting him. And if you look at the other side, same thing here. It's even got a little keeper here so you can put this through here and it's out of your way. Nice and clean. So once that's done, you're ready to go. Before you just jump right on them, sometimes it's a good idea to walk them a little bit and make sure he's comfortable and kind of moves everything you need. Just like that, you can hop on them and go. And I'll show you one other way. Tie a Latigo if you want. The other way to do this would be to do this. We'll go like that and we'll put it up through here. put this through here. Like that. And keep it kind of loose. Don't get it all the way tight. You got a little room to play with. And it's almost like tying a tie or something. You know, bring it down and bring it like this. And then you'll kind of... this way, if you don't have a hole that's close enough in the latigo and you want kind of a custom fit, you can go like that too. And that's all you do. And the excess, you just stick up here. That's all there is to it. Thanks for watching, and good luck.